So George, you know that networking is a very key part when applying for a job, especially here in Vancouver. I don't know in the States or in Toronto, maybe you can tell me about that. So what tips do you have in terms of networking and how can job seekers use networking tool, especially if some of them are not used to going to events and they are very introvert and shy? What can you say about that?
Yeah, so that's a loaded question. I'm gonna sort of take it in two parts. The first part I'll say is if you're in North America, because, and I'm gonna refrain from the question to give you context as to why I start there. In different parts of the world, networking is viewed very differently. That's something I personally learned and I had to kind of mature my thinking on. And the fact that, you know, in places like the Middle East, like Europe, like in Russia, when you see networking, people would literally walk the other way. Like it doesn't happen the same way. And I've talked to friends who are from Russia who tell me, listen, when we came to Canada, this whole concept of networking was so foreign to me. Mm-hmm. So I just start there to tell you that in North America, it happens very differently.
Yes.
The one thing I would say is for me personally, networking and getting comfortable with it is more like a muscle, right? Like mm-hmm. it's not something, again, that you're just innately great at. Even for people who are extroverts, it's not necessarily like day one, you just know what to do. Couple things to do to start off, right? I would say obviously leverage platforms like LinkedIn, even platforms like Instagram. They're great ways, I say, to scale your network, meaning to find, connect, and build relationships with many people across, you know, different industries, different countries, in a way that it wouldn't be possible without these channels. The thing I would say too is don't just rely on these channels to build an inflated network. So what I mean by that is you see a lot of people who all they do every second of the day are always on LinkedIn. When I say leverage, I mean actively engage, be there daily, share posts, connect with other people, like, comment, whatever. But it shouldn't be the only thing you put your eggs in, right? Like kind of diversify your efforts and your time. With that said, you go to events, you know, put yourself out there. Like, and maybe start small. It doesn't have to be like a massive conference where you're like, holy shit, where do I start? Mm-hmm. Go to a small meetup, right? Like look at meetup.com, find maybe a topic, a group that you're interested in. It could be gaming, it could be sports, it could be business, finance, whatever it is. Go to that, meet people who are like-minded and start getting connected, right? And all that means is you go to the event, you know, whatever the style is, typically you'll register. There's a bit of a networking. There might be a panel, a fireside chat. And I would say one of the things you should probably do at some point is go by yourself.
Yeah.
I have to do this a lot for work, you know, but that's one of the ways I got very comfortable with it. So because I'm alone, I'm not sticking with a colleague. I think that's one of the mistakes sometimes is you go with people you know, and you spend 6 hours with people yeah. you know. And that defeats the point of a networking event. You're supposed to build relationships with other people.
I agree.
And so that comfort is definitely a muscle, and even the courage, right? Just to get outside of your house at 7 p.m. after work and go to this meetup. Like sometimes it's not something you want to do, but just tell yourself. And trust me, even today, I still have that in the back of my mind sometimes, right? I'll be tired and I'm like, oh, all I want to do is just, you know, sit back. I don't really feel like going. But I just remind myself every time I go to these things, something good comes out of it. You know, a colleague of mine always tells me, like, nothing good ever comes from sitting at your desk. In sales, that's critical, right? You have to be out there at times, depending on your role too. And the last thing I'll say is, back to that sort of storytelling, when you're networking, the biggest key I'll tell you, especially when you're talking to someone, Mayor, is show interest in them.
Yes.
Always. That's the easiest thing you can do. Man, if you're an introvert, the networking event should be the easiest thing for you. Okay, let's say I meet you. The conversation shouldn't be about me. Immediately, I'll say, hey, Mayor, how's it going?
I'm doing well.
So what brings you to the event? Is this the first time you attend the meetup or what's...
Yeah, I wanted to meet new people and see the topic was interesting for me. That's why I came.
Amazing. Well, tell me about yourself. What do you do? What's your background? What's your story, career? I'd love to know.
Okay, yeah. Yeah, it's not about you.
Exactly.
It's all about the other person.
That's right. And then right here, you have like 2 or 3 minutes of that person talking about themselves. Why that's important is because when they do that, you're listening, hopefully,
yeah.
and you're going to find points where you can resonate.
Yes.
So maybe Mayor will tell me, oh, well, you know, I just came from Lebanon. I'm now working in a recruiting company. Oh, interesting. So I'm picking off. No way, I'm Lebanese too. And from there, you just take it off.
Right. Yeah. And I always have this in my mind. Whenever I go to any networking event, I at least meet 3 new people. That's my goal. If I meet more, that's great. If less, I would try at least one person. And I agree with you. Sometimes, especially here in Vancouver, it's very small. And some of the events I go, I see the same people. I hang out with them just to catch up. But I always try to meet at least one new person and have a connection with them. And then grow from there. You never know, right? Yeah. Again, thank you for sharing that, George. And for the audience watching and listening, if you have any other tips in terms of networking, please leave it in the comment section. Like and share the video, subscribe to the channel, and tune in tomorrow for my final question with George.